Hiya, Mick here, and in today's video we're looking at spring and neap tides. In our previous video on tides, we looked at how the tide comes in and goes out, or what affects it. But in this video we're going to look at another factor, that being the sun. Before we look at the sun's effect on the tide, we're actually going to look just at tidal range. Tidal range is just the difference between low water and high water. This graphic here is showing us the average tidal range. So on to the spring tides. Looking in on the 7th of May, we can see the little white circle showing us that we actually have a full moon. This full moon means that the sun, the earth and the moon are all in the line. We can see the full of the moon, and this additional gravitational pull pulls the earth's mass of water even more, giving us a higher high tide and a lower low tide. If we look at this in our graphic for tidal range, we see that lower low tide and higher high tide gives us a much greater tidal range, the spring tidal range. And if we compare this to the mean tidal range, we see it's quite a bit more. This happens once every 28 days when we have our full moon. But it also happens when we have a new moon. Seeing here on the 22nd of May, we can see the black circle, which signifies a new moon. A new moon being when the moon is in between the sun and the earth, so we only just see the outline of it. It has the same effect on the tide as the full moon, that extra gravitational pull, pulling that mass of water more to one side, giving us that higher high tide and lower low tide. Due to the fact it takes the moon 28 days to rotate around the earth, that means we'll get a spring tide twice in that 28 day period. Next, we're going to look at neap tides. Neap tides is when the moon is perpendicular to that line between the sun and the earth. So we just see a half moon. Looking in our tide tables, we can see on the 14th of May, we can see that little half moon symbol, meaning that a neap tide is due to occur. The moon's gravitational force pulling the tide one way and the sun pulling it a different way means we have a smaller tidal range. Looking back at our tidal range graphic, we can see that the low water is quite high, but the high water is quite low, giving us that neap tidal range, which you can see is smaller than the mean tidal range, but quite a lot smaller than the spring tidal range. So this half moon, or neap tide, means we get a lower high tide, but a higher low tide. This happens again another 14 days later. Here on the 30th of May, you can see the other half moon shape on our tide tables. With the moon pulling the Earth's mass of water one way, and the sun pulling it a different way, ends up with a lower high tide, but a higher low tide, meaning a smaller tidal range. Just to finish off then, we get our spring tides when we have a full moon and 14 days later when we have our new moon. And then we have our neap tides when we have that half moon, when the moon is perpendicular to the line between the sun and the earth. I'll have more videos coming out soon, but please like, share, and if you're on YouTube, subscribe.